Friends, welcome to Coding Station. Today we'll be learning text-based coding, and as you can see on my screen, I have a slide open for you that shows HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML means hypertext markup language, CSS means cascading style sheet, and JavaScript means JavaScript, and its short form can be JS, as you can see. So first we'll be learning a bit on all these. Then we'll be moving on the text-based coding. So today's video will be a compact one, and it will be a proper coding video which will show text-based coding. And from block-based coding, we have already shifted to text-based coding. Already I have posted a video on small basics. So today we are going to start with CodePen. Okay, so what is HTML? HTML is used to code the content of the website. So whatever content we have to add in our website, we code it in the HTML part. Once I show you my CodePen website on the screen, then you'll be able to understand everything. But for now, just learn these parts. The HTML is used to code the content of the website. CSS is used to code the style of the content of the website. So like we used to fill the labels, used to fill the text inputs in Code Studio and Thunderbolt. Similarly, this HTML will be used to do the same thing, but that will be done not like we'll click on a text input, go to the design component, then we'll write inside. No, we have a particular code for it that has a syntax that also I'll show you. But currently in this slide, this much is written, that HTML is used to code the content of the website. CSS is used to code the style of the content of the website, like the font width, font color, font style, etc. And JavaScript is used to code the behavior in stern terms of events or actions of the content. So it's the coding part. Basically, JavaScript is the coding part. HTML is the text inputs, labels, and buttons, etc. Content part, whatever is written on it, like for example a button has a submit written on it, we have to code it in the HTML part. The CSS part is used to style the content of the website, and the JavaScript part is used to code the behavior in terms of the actions or events of the content. For example, here you can see Google and input, Google search, I am feeling lucky. These are done with the help of HTML. These writings are done with the help of the HTML. Here the font, you already can see that this font is done with the help of CSS, and whatever coding is done with the help of JavaScript. So this is the basic of HTML, that HTML has two sections, the head section and the body section. So for it's compared with a human being. A human being has a head and a body. Body is mostly bigger than the head. So one thing I should tell you, that when we are starting with the HTML head part, for example, we are giving a heading and we want to write whatever will be written in that heading, we have to use this part. We have to give this syntax head by putting these two arrows. Then we have to write the code in this line or any more lines we need. Then we have to press enter. Then this arrow slash head and another arrow. This will show that the heading is completed. Similarly, we have to code the body. So here an example is given how we write it. Just go through it once. Okay, so now we shift to hypertext markup language, or HTML, as I told you earlier. Now why do we need to learn HTML? HTML, we need to learn HTML tags to create web page content. Okay, so HTML is necessary to create the web page content, whatever I have to write in my web page. Cascading styling sheet, CSS. I've already explained HTML and CSS to you in the first slide, so I don't think I have to explain it to you again and again, but still I'm just reading out the slide once to you. Using CSS, we can redefine the look of the HTML elements. So we can redefine the look, we can just give it a stylish look using CSS. I know the heading of this slide is cut, so that's not my fault because the slide is made like that. This slide is not made by me, it's made by Vita Junior. So whatever I was taught, I'm just showing it to you. So using CSS, we can redefine the look of the HTML elements. So this is an example, like we're setting the background color to blue and the color to text color to red. So this will show like this. Alright, so I think this part is understood. Now, as I told you, in my last slide, I'll show you the syntax. So, we have all the syntax written of the HTML, CSS and the JavaScript over here. Kindly go through it once because it's really very important for our next videos of coding. So, HTML syntax is tag value tag. So, what is tag? If it's a button, then the tag is button. If it's a label, then the tag is label. If it's an input, then the tag is input. And the value, what is value? The writing which should be written inside is a value. So example is given already, button, click me, buttons. This slash, I hope it's understood. This shows that buttons HTML part is over. Now CSS, selector, property, value. Selector, this curly bracket, property, value, another curly bracket. Okay, so this is a bit wrong. So please don't mind because this won't be this bracket. Okay, this will be this bracket. So I'm just writing it down over here with blue color. This will be this curly bracket. Okay. So property value, semicolon, and this curly bracket. An example is already given over here. Button, curly bracket starts. Background color blue, curly bracket closes. So we set the button's background color to blue. So already we have set the button's HTML part, whatever is written inside the button. Now we were just changing the cascading styling shape, which is the designing of the button. I mean the background color I have chosen. Now in this JavaScript, the function name, in the function, the name inside two arrows, then one bracket, another bracket, one curly bracket, one empty line, and another curly bracket. So this line can be many, as many as you want, but this curly bracket should be below the coding line, whatever you code. An example is given over here. So this was all of my slides I have. All right. So this is a project which I did of my class. I'll not show you the class activity because it's on myself and I don't want to show you that. So I'll show you the project which is made on MS Dhoni. Okay. So the HTML part is coded already. So this in brackets H1, MS Dhoni, H1 closed with a slash. So this is shown like this. Like this is the heading one or the header one or the head one, whatever you call it. Is over here. Image source equal to. So now how did I get this image source? So I can go to internet, I can search for MS Dhoni, I can copy the link of that particular image and I can paste it over here. I'll show you how to. Just give me a second. Okay, so I've copied this link of MS Dhoni from an internet site. So friends, here are many images of MS Dhoni. I can select anyone. For example, if I want to select this one, I'll right click on it and I'll see copy image link. Okay, so I'll copy this image link and I can paste it over here. So I just had shown you an example. So image source equal to, in double quotes, the whole link will be written. This is a kind of big link up for this image. So like this, I get the image link, a very big link. All right, now P means paragraph. MS Dhoni was born on 7 July 1981, and I have just written everything on MS Dhoni in this paragraph. So this is one of my projects, as I told you. So the topic was given in my project that it has to be a sports fan page, and the name was also given of whom I have to make my work on. So it's already done. So paragraph means P. So my name is Oishi, so headed to by Oishi and headed 3, thank you. Header 3 doesn't always have to be on top. If also I compared it with a human being's head, it always doesn't have to be on top. Any small writings can be header. And any big writings can be paragraph, copy, or body. We won't come to the JavaScript part right now. So we would be in the CSS part, I mean the cascading styling shit part only. So paragraph, font family, monospace, color. This color I have chosen from color picker in Google. I'll also show you that how I did it. But before that, I'll finish this part. Text align center. So if it was not center, this would have been like, if I would have written left, it would have been aligned to the left side. Okay, so it's done. Alright, so in Google, I had searched for color picker and in Google Chrome. So in none of the other web browsers will get it. Alright, so the link of this color picker is also available below in the description box and not my project. So from here, I can choose any, like I like this screen so much, I'm fond of it. So here you can see the hex code. So I'll just copy this hex code along with the hashtag. So once I paste it in my project, it will be done. So guys, I hope this was clear and you can create such projects now. Not only projects, you can create your own web page similarly. And I think that there won't be any issue with this project anymore or anything. You can let me know in the comment section if you have any query, any doubt or anything. And so don't forget to like, don't forget to put a thumbs up to this video if you like it. And subscribe to Coding Station if you already haven't. And this is Coding Station signing off.